short presentation of my company. I'm not sure that everybody knows us. The MAPFRE Group has 40,000 employees, around 40,000 employees, and we are present in 47 countries. We are the sixth non-life insurer in Europe, leader in Latin America, and recently we acquired the operations of Direline in Germany and in Italy. And we were one of the pioneers of telematics in the world. So we launched possibly one of the first products in Europe. It was 2007, and it was called the Y Car, focused on the youngster segment. About me, I'm the responsible, I'm the head of innovation in the group. I run a team of around 70 professionals, split in 15 countries, not 12, the slide is wrong. And essentially, my job consists on, we have three different timelines in terms of innovation inside the company. One is the short term, which is more focused on digital transformation and the impacts of the technology change and making the value proposition evolve. And it relates more with the presentation we have seen during this morning. And we have a second timeline and a third timeline where I'm focusing, which is sort of elaborating scenarios about the future. The third one is about elaborating those scenarios and understanding where the world is heading, where the main transformations we are seeing in the economy are impacting insurance. And therefore, based on that conclusions, we act on the second timeline. I don't know if we are talking about 1 to 3 years for the first one, from 3 to 6, 7 years for the second one, and then for the third one, it's beyond. What I'm going to talk about is relates to the third timeline. So we're going to talk about disruption and the future of one of our main product lines, which is motor. I had the occasion to meet Peter Bale, the MIT professor, a couple of years ago. And this slide, the one I'm reproducing, it's not mine, it's Peter Bale's. It was sort of a wake-up call for us. Peter brought up the subject of the business ecosystems. And the idea is a lot of the industries, a lot of the sectors where we are operating are moving from being a traditional value chain to an ecosystem. So no, it's not about sequential business process that elaborates one part of the product and then the next one and then the next one and finally reaches the end customer. It's about something which is more collaborative, where a key player relates with the end customer, and there are other players that are provide applications for the end customer. And when he elaborated these metrics in the other axis, the first axis was the one I was mentioning, value chain versus ecosystem. And the other axis was the knowledge of the end customer that a certain player might have in that specific industry. So from partial to complete. And well, it was pretty obvious, no? Then, okay, what am I? I'm a motor insurer. What am I going to be? Where am I today? Where am I going to be? If I'm able to build an ecosystem and be in the center of the relationship with the customer, and I have complete knowledge of the end customer, I'm going to be an ecosystem driver, which is kind of the sweet spot of the matrix. So I'm able to know very well the needs of my end customer. I'm the natural partner, the natural interaction point to solve certain number of problems with him. And therefore, I'm going to capture a lot of value of the ecosystem. But if I have partial knowledge and I'm in an ecosystem, I'm going to be sort of a modular producer. So that was kind of a wake-up call for me. Why? I'm going to save this slide for later on. Because if I'm able to build an ecosystem, I'm going to be able to maintain my profitability. But if not, I'm going to be a supplier for other partners. And what is happening in the world? That a lot of the economic activity is moving around new ecosystems. The first one, for instance, is the Apple one. So I'm not explaining anything new for you, but this is kind of the paradigm of an ecosystem. It's Apple reaching end customers, having an intimate relationship with those customers, and that includes payment means, that includes details of the customer, that includes a lot of information of what the customer is doing, that has an emotional side as well. And then we have third-party application services that, through that main player, are delivering value to the end customer. But it's pretty obvious, the one who is running the show and the one who is making money is the main player in the center of the ecosystem. I don't have to tell you that these guys are more and more covering different aspects of the economic activity. So payment means, so banks, be careful, is one of the areas where they are considering capture value. But it's not only about that. Android is another ecosystem. So we are building the whole rationale is the same. I mean, we are chasing brands, possibly some details, but the paradigm is exactly the same. The model is the same. Then something has started to happen recently. All those ecosystems are starting to become interoperable among them. So at the beginning, they were tempted to have closed environments. So if I'm Apple, I stay with Apple, and I cannot do anything with the Android. So if I develop an application, I have to develop an application for a certain ecosystem. I have a service, I deliver that service exclusively through one of the ecosystems. But then they realized that it was not the best way of enriching the business. And those ecosystems started to be interoperable. It's about the Google world, it's about the Microsoft world, it's about the Apple world. Possibly some might include here Amazon as well. We might include here Alibaba or the Asian players. But the idea is exactly the same. What am I telling you about this if I'm going to talk about the car? Well, the central idea of this is that the car is the new ecosystem. Google has identified as the, and they have actually said it in the press, as the, I don't remember if it's the fifth or the sixth window to the end customer, whatever it is. It's one additional window to the end customer. So someone that has built one of those ecosystems cannot allow not to stay in the world of the car. I'm bringing a Tesla slide. I've been using this slide for 3 years now. It's kind of obsolete, but it's still, I said, everybody knows Tesla, so don't worry. I'm not going to explain you about Tesla, anything about Tesla. But the idea for me, and it stays very valid, is that the guy that designed this car, which is the Model S, defined it as an iPhone on wheels. So it's kind of the headline that summarizes a lot of the ideas I'm putting on the table now. It's an iPhone on wheels because, first of all, it has wheels, has a battery, but it has an operating system. It's always connected to the internet. This operating system updates over the air. This operating system will have a software developer kit for application suppliers. It will have application on the dashboard. So we are opening the door. So the car, it's another ecosystem with a lot of technology involved in it. Are we able to live? We as an insurer, insurers, motor insurers, are we able to live not considering that reality? I'm not going to answer the question. the thing here is that the car industry is realizing that this change is starting to happen. Therefore, car manufacturers want to build their own ecosystems or at least participate on the driving seat of this transformation, so they don't become just hardware manufacturers for the industry. They have very present what happened 20 years ago when PC manufacturers start to lose value, when operating system suppliers started to run the business and control the business, having this platform view. This comes from the Wall Street Journal. It's a 1 year old article, and essentially it plots in a map in the Valley area all the development and labs that manufacturers have. So this is a very relevant shift in the automaker industry. Cars used to be designed in Detroit, Wolfsburg, all those places that are, you know, historical places for the development of the car, but it's not anymore about that. Cars are starting to be designed, and business models are starting to be designed in the Valley. And in the Valley, they are learning to do business the way Microsoft, Google, Apple are doing business. So building ecosystems. And manufacturers want to build ecosystems. And the car is going to be an additional ecosystem for this. So I haven't talked about insurance yet, and I'm realizing I'm running out of time, but here we go. Operating systems in the car. We are seeing different attempts to build common platforms for the car. You have on one side the proprietary system, so every manufacturer is trying sort of building it. Renault has the Airlink, and they offer solutions for insurers. You have OnStar, which is kind of a solution that comes from GM, but they plan to offer it to everybody. Then you have Apple CarPlay, you have Android Auto, MirrorLink, which is the Microsoft solution. So these are the operating systems. But what about us? What about motor insurance in this environment? I think insurers, we are in a kind of situation like this in this environment. Why? For me, this is kind of the message I wanted to convey to you. On everything I have said is the introduction to this. We have lived in a world when anything that related to the car experience has been sold and bundled. No? You bought the car. You used to buy the car in a dealer. Then you went to the bank for the funding for the finance. You contract the road assistance from a club. You used to do it in the past. The maintenance, you have the repair shop, which was your the guy you rely on that was close to your home. And then you buy the insurance in an agent. And that has really changed since the last years. So first movement was the manufacturers started to build their own finance companies. Then they set up banks, and they start to package, to bundle finance with the car. And they started to offer road assistance. And they are starting to offer now maintenance. And they are starting to offer now insurance in different models. So we are moving to a world where, in a second stage, we are going to find bundled value propositions, where the insurance is nothing else but a part of that bundled proposition. And then we are moving to a third stage, which is the mobility as a service. So I'm not going to have to buy anymore a car. So you have certain leasing models already in the market, but it's not dominant. But in the future, we're going to see something which is, I'm going to buy something as a service. And I want to buy something that solves my mobility problems. This is a little bit, this is going to change in some years. And especially, one key driver for this are the autonomous driving systems. So anything that has to, that makes the car more autonomous will support this transformation. What about motor insurance distribution in this scenario? I think, first of all, what we are seeing is a process that is going from B2C, it shouldn't say B2B, the first stage, so from a B2C distribution, so we insurers went either through a distributor that was on the insurance industry, so a broker or a tied agent or an untied agent, we sold the insurance to the end customer, the motor insurance to the end customer. We are starting to see how this moves to a B2B2C, so we have to do it through the dealer or through the brand. And in the future, it will be just merely a B2B distribution because it will be embedded in the car. The different models that can be built here are, well, potentially very different, but I see appealing to very clearly. One is the walled garden, which is the traditional selection of 3-4 offers that are offered to the end customer in the moment of the sale of the car. Manufacturers are opting for a single offer. So some manufacturers have already done joint ventures with insurance companies. What are the key success factors for operating in this business? I think it's, first of all, a motor insurance company that wants to be in this game has to have a global footprint, or at least build it. It's very difficult to be a local player and be a relevant partner for a manufacturer. Secondly, it's about building value chain management capabilities that can support building a new experience with the car. And finally, it's about the integration with the manufacturer on building this customer experience. So it's about integrating insurance applications in order to enhance the customer experience where an insurer has something to say, which is essentially in the moment of the claim, possibly in the moment of prevention, and for sure taking into account in pricing anything that regards the ADAS or the safety systems in the car. And that's all words about the presentation, so thank you very much.